Hey, Mitchell, here's another book that I like. It's called Gordon the Goat. The stories and pictures are by Monroe Leaf. And there's Gordon. You see him in the corner? Gordon was a goat. And he lived in Texas. Gordon liked to eat. He didn't care what he ate. He would try anything. Most of the time, he ate leaves from the mesquite trees. But he would just as soon try a dish towel or a delicious ham if he could get it. He's standing on a box. And every now and then, Gordon would bite a cactus, but he was sorry every time he did. Gordon lived on a ranch with a lot of other goats. He didn't work very hard. All Gordon did was to go on being Gordon day after day, and now and then he would get his hair cut. The men who cut his hair called it mohair. They sold it to other people. The people used the mohair to make cloth and to stuff cushions. That was all right with Gordon. He didn't care what the men did with his hair, just so they didn't nick him while they were cutting it off. Excuse me. Some of the goats on the ranch were called lead goats. They were called lead goats because the other goats followed them around. Whenever a lead goat got tired of staying in one place, he would go to another place. All the other goats would tag along behind him. Sometimes the new place was better than the old place, and sometimes it was worse. Better or worse, when the lead goat went, all the rest of the goats went along. Gordon went too. He didn't know why. He just did what all the rest of the goats did. He didn't really think about it. But it took Gordon so long to get going, all the other goats were ahead of him. Gordon was always at the tail end of the line. One day, the lead goat got tired of staying where he was, so he set out to find another place. He remembered seeing some new weeds on the other side of a hill. Off he went to find the new weeds. The rest of the goats followed him, with Gordon at the tail end of the line. After a long, hot walk, the goats found the new weeds. Gordon ate some. The weeds were not very good, and soon Gordon didn't feel very well. He was sorry he had come along at all. Gordon sat down on the side of the hill. He made up his mind to stay there until he felt better. But just when Gordon was getting comfortable, the lead goat set off for another place. Away he went, and the other goats followed him. The very last goat was Gordon, who really didn't feel like going at all. Gordon walked and walked. The hot sun beat down on him, and Gordon began to wonder, why had he come along? Why didn't he do some thinking for himself? Why did he follow all the other goats? Who were following the lead goat? Just because that was what they always did? It didn't make sense to Gordon. All of a sudden, Gordon saw something way off ahead of all the goats. It was big, dark, dusty-looking thing, and it was coming right at them. It began on the ground and went clear up into the sky. It was the biggest thing Gordon had ever seen. The thing was coming at them faster and faster. Gordon wished that the lead goat would turn around and go somewhere else, but the lead goat went on walking straight ahead. And so the goats went walking straight ahead, too. The thing came at them until all the goats were right in the middle of it. Do you know what that's called, Mitchell? Guess we'll find out. It was a twister. Now, a twister, or a tornado, is no fun to be in, and Gordon was scared. Up he flew in a black cloud. It tossed him around and around. It tossed him upside down and downside up. Look at all the stuff in the tornado. You see it, Mitchell? Now Gordon was really sorry that he had ever eaten those new weeds. Oh, poor Gordon. First he turned yellow. Look at his eyes, you see, he's not feeling good. Oh, and then he turned green, and then he was sick. Gordon felt sorry for himself. He'd never felt so sorry for himself before. When he thought he just couldn't last any longer, he saw the old lead goat go spinning past him. The old goat went higher and higher. He looked as if he felt worse than Gordon. Just then, Gordon was blown out of the twister. He landed with a thud in the middle of a field. The field was soft enough to keep him from breaking his bones, but it was hard enough to hurt a lot. After a long time, Gordon got up. He was stiff and sore. He ached all over. But Gordon knew something now that he would never forget. Never again would he follow along just because everyone else did. He was going to find out first where he was going, why he was going, and what he was going to do when he got there. Gordon does his own thinking now. He gets along much better than before. The end.